Is college baseball dead? Well, today we talk about that. And I want to know your answer. I want to know your response to that question. So go ahead and comment below. I'm going to talk to you about what my thoughts are, and I'm going to explain why I'm even having this thought. So definitely tune in all the way to the end so you can join in the discussion. Again, I want you to be participating in this by going down and commenting. So with that being said, let's jump into it. So if you guys haven't already heard, the Power Five conferences are meeting and have been talking this entire time during the pandemic. And the Power Five conferences are the ACC, the Big 12, the Big 10, the SEC, and Pac-12. And they're talking to see if they're going to postpone the season or cancel it entirely. And what does that mean, and how does that affect college baseball? Well, football brings in a lot of money to these college programs, especially the big college programs. And so that affects the other programs. If there's no season for football, then the other programs are going to get hit hard. I mean, some of them may even go under because the TV deals, they won't get any of that money from the TV deals. And as you can see with my alma mater, UCLA, Under Armour deal has been taken away from them because during this time it's not profitable for big sponsorship. So these programs are going to get hit hard. That's going to change a lot. I will say this, that there are some schools out there that do not rely on their sports programs, such as Ivy League schools, D3. I think these schools are not going to be hit as hard because they fundraise for themselves. But I feel like some other programs are going to be hit really hard. What should you do? Well, you're going to have to adjust and adapt. You know, if you're a baseball player, that's part of the game. The people that can adjust the best and adapt, those are the ones that are successful in this game. So in this situation, you're going to have to adjust, you're going to have to adapt because of the current situations that's going on right now. And the reason I say you need to adjust and adapt is because it's not like traditional times where you go to showcases and you go to camps and you get recruited. Shoot, during this time, the time that I'm filming this, some college coaches can't even recruit right now. So they're waiting until August 31st. So like I said, it's not like traditional times. In fact, I think it's going to go back to like the early 1900s. Basically, there were so many baseball teams out there, and they were mostly independent ball teams. And I think that's where we're headed. We're headed back to that like model. And the reason I say that is because Manfred also wants to eliminate all the minor league teams, not all of them, but certain minor league teams. So there's a long road to get to the big leagues, and he wants to shorten that so it makes it faster so the player can get to the big leagues quicker and doesn't take 5 years to get to the MLB. Which means, you know, fans are going to be connected with their stars at a younger age. So I get why he wants to do that. And with that being said, I'm saying, you know, I think things are going to change. There's going to be more minor league teams. And if college baseball isn't going to be playing, those good players in college baseball are going to start playing an independent ball as well. So you're going to have an influx of a lot of great players that are just hanging around playing in their local area and getting on these independent ball teams. As you can tell right now, or if you haven't heard, but there's a lot of players in the minor leagues that are in their local area playing in the adult league. So now that competition has gotten way better. They're throwing 93, 94. I got invited just recently, and guys are, you know, throwing hard out there. The game's changing, and the economy of baseball is changing. I think it's going to continuously do that for a bit of time. I'm not saying college baseball is going to be completely dead, because I believe it'll come back in a few years, but I think it's going to be hit hard. I think, you know, funding is going to hit them. The recruiting process is going to slow down. You won't see guys getting recruited in 9th grade and 10th grade or 8th grade. You'll see them get recruited back in the 11th and 12th grade, and just things are just going to be much different. So with that being said, how do you take advantage of this opportunity? Well, the first thing I would do is I would continue to improve my skills. So if you're a position player, improve your defense, improve your offense, improve your arm strength, improve the 5 tools so that you can still stand out. Because if you go and play in these independent ball teams, you want to be, you know, one of the better players so that when you do get recruited, you get a chance to go and live out your dream. And the other side of it, let's say you want to play college ball, I would start reaching out to schools that aren't associated with big football teams, that don't rely on those schools, because they might get hit hard. And to be honest, there could be several schools that are going to go under. You might be like, no, that doesn't make sense. You know, NCAA has so much money, they're going to, you know, throw it back in. But I don't think so. Let's just hypothetically, let's just say that there's no baseball, or there's no football season. And the way things are going, you might not need to actually go to class. So you're going to spend $40,000 a year and not go into class. To me, I just feel like people aren't going to do that. So I think it's going to really take a big hit in the entire system, the entire college ecosystem. So I would say keep getting yourself better and start going out to these local adult leagues, start playing. The scouts are still going to be out there recruiting, and they're going to start hearing about the better players, and they're going to be watching, and they're going to send that info out to the major league clubs. As far as college goes, start sending it out to schools that aren't reliant of their football and basketball teams. So let's say Ivy League schools, you know, you got your Harvards, your Yales, your Brown University. Start sending out to those schools, and then like D3 schools, which they don't give scholarships as well. So those schools aren't going to be hit as hard because they're going to be funding their own program. So that's something that I believe, but I want to know what you guys think. So go ahead and comment below and let me know your thoughts. I'm interested. And again, let's be civil about it and let's start this discussion. It's just something I was thinking about and I wanted to share. So I appreciate you watching. Please subscribe to the channel. We do baseball stories, baseball tips, breakdowns of MLB players, and we're going to put out some more content as well so you can get better. But thinking about you, hope you're doing well. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I'll see you in the next video.